Hello, I'm Harry Forbes from ARC Advisory Group. I'm here with Joerg Schubert, who is the head of product and portfolio for ABB Process Automation. Joerg, welcome to the ARC Forum. It's nice to have you here.
Thank you, Harry.
I have to give you a compliment and ABB on the paper that you published last year called the DCS of the Future and the Requirements. Could you maybe outline a little bit of that paper? I thought it was an excellent read.
Well, I mean, for us, this is a paper that is articulating in what direction process automation is moving. I think we have exciting times. Automation have been seen as a commodity for quite some years, but with the digitization and the changes on technology around us, suddenly we have been able to give this a clear new direction to address all the changing markets around us.
And I really haven't heard or haven't seen anything so well articulated as the first half of that paper in terms of talking about the customer pain points. But the other point there that you raised is in the paper is getting the continuity so that people can move into this kind of future scenario that so many people see. How do you do that? How do you make sure?
Well, I mean, I think we are well known from our history in merging several DCS systems from different brands that over time kind of merge into ABB, and we allowed them to stay on the technology by evolving it into the future. With the latest technology that we are seeing, we are way more enabled for taking applications that we have done in the past, containerize them, and move them on to new hardware platforms. So this way, we don't want to start over and do everything new. We will evolve our installations and technology that we have right now, primarily with the promoted brands of 800XA and Symphony Plus, and adding this technology into it. And that will, over time, completely transform this to an automation system that has cybersecurity built in, is exposing data, but still keeps the key elements of a DCS in place, which are safety, easiness, and then reliability of the operation.
It seems like that would have a lot of impact on the engineering effort required to build a system.
Well, I would say the opposite. What we are trying to do is, number one, we are containerizing the application elements that we have. You need to make sure that your application that you have done in the past can move forward. So one element of the DCS vision is that we want to keep that execution capability forward into the new technology. And then we are working on breaking the installations and the applications apart, containerize them so that pre-tested smart modules can be reused also for greenfield. And we think that the evolution is key to stay in the marketplace. There's been so much investment done by our customers. And if we would start over by introducing new technology requiring to start from scratch, it would be preventative for that installed base. And the installed base today is a greenfield that would be coming in tomorrow and then 5 years down the road has, based on the changes in the marketplace, changes to their business needs, now suddenly different needs. And we also want to protect this future investment.
With the future automation system, it's going to play kind of a different role. It's going to have different components, much more standardized, much more common. What do you see as the kind of role of what kind of business model you're going to see in IIoT and automation in the future?
I mean, these two worlds are converging. So I would say that the DCS role remains to provide a safe, an efficient and a reliable environment for automating the core. But then the additional task is that this automation system, with its modularity, with its capability to tie in network-connected devices, has the task to provide data of equipment and of the process to the consuming digital world around. So the DCS is one input provider for the digitization. And in that part, we are seeing kind of that from an automation perspective, we will see way more services provided to our customers in the future to come.
Joerg, what about the workforce? The workforce is changing dramatically.
Yes.
And as this new technology and new solutions reach the workforce, what are you doing to address them?
Well, I mean, we have in the past already had the goal to help our operators to make the right decisions with the information available. With our aspect object technology, we have exposed as much as possible information that is needed for making the right decision. Going forward, with the generations changing, we have less trained users now, so the system has to take more of this over, and we have to have the system providing pre-processed data that then makes maybe a less trained operator still coming within short time to the right decision. We also want to support the operators for producing at a higher level of quality, so meaning that the repetitiveness of the operations has to be supported by the system. So we want to augment the operator and what they were doing, and we want to give them the information that they need for then finally decide. The human in the loop is still needed, and I think this will stay this for the years to come. Mm-hmm. Ultimately, the goal is to get to an autonomous operation where machine learning and AI are influencing that more.
Well, where the person can do what a person can do better.
Yes.
Okay, well, thank you very much. I appreciate you being with us today, and I hope you'll come again and we can explore this in the future, George.
Thank you, Harry. Thanks for having me.
My pleasure. This is Harry Forbes from ARC Advisory Group. My guest has been George Schubert from ABB Process Automation. Thank you for watching.